Hey guys, you guys are watching Black Pen and Red Pen.
Yay!
Yay!
Okay, in this video, we'll integrate x to the third power times inverse tangent of x. We'll first do this the regular way, and then we'll do this with power series. I think you guys will like power series a lot compared to the regular way, but I don't know, let me know. Anyway, here we go. To integrate this, we will actually just do the DI method, namely integration by parts. So let's go ahead and pick something to be differentiated and something else to be integrated. And don't forget to set up the plus minus on the side to get ready. I don't want to integrate inverse tangent because to do that, we will have to do integration by parts again. So let me differentiate inverse tangent and let me just integrate x to the third power. And when we integrate this, we get 1 over 4 x to the fourth power. When we differentiate that, we get 1 over 1 plus x squared, just like that. And now we can put the answers, the next steps together. First of all, we multiply this and that. That's the first part of the answer. So we have this times that, which is 1 over 4 x to the fourth power times inverse tangent of x. And that's the first part. Then we are going to multiply the second row. And remember, when we multiply a row, this right here is still an integral. Man, we've been doing this since 2015, right? For the DI method and all that stuff. Good things. Anyway, this is a minus. So don't forget, this is going to be a negative integral. So I'll put this down right here. Negative. Let me just do everything blue here. All right, so we have this times that. Let me put the 1 over 4 all the way in the front. And then x to the fourth power times that is just x to the fourth power on the top over this for the denominator, which is 1 plus x to the second power. And we have that done, just like that. Now, how can we deal with this integral though? Well, on the top, it's x to the fourth power. On the bottom, here we have 1 plus x to the second power. The degree on the top is too big, so we have to just do long division to take care of that. So I will just do it right here real quick. Let's see. I will put this right here inside, x to the fourth power inside, and let me do that. 1 plus, actually, let me write it as x squared plus 1. It's nicer this way. And let's see. We need x squared. X squared times this is x to the fourth power, and x squared times that is plus x squared. And don't forget we subtract. This is just a polynomial division. And then we'll see that this is 0 minus that, which is negative x squared. And can we go again? Yes, because we can put negative 1. Negative 1 times this is negative x squared. Negative 1 times 1 is minus 1. And when we subtract, we will get this is 0, and 0 minus negative 1 is just positive 1. So in another word, this part is just going to be this and then that. So this is actually not that bad. Let me put this down. We still have the negative 1 over 4 integral. Again, this part, after the long division, this is the quotient, namely x squared minus 1. And we have the remainder, which is 1. So we have to add 1 over the original denominator. And of course, we can put it down this way, 1 plus x squared, like that. And this is still in terms of that integral. Now, we will just put down everything, right? So let me write this down right here. We have 1 over 4 x to the fourth power inverse tangent of x. And then we have the negative 1 over 4. So let me just write this down. Minus 1 over 4. I'll open the parentheses for the result of the integration. Integrating this, we get 1 over 3 x to the third power. And then this is negative 1. Integrating that in the x world, we get minus x. And when we integrate 1 over 1 plus x squared, we get inverse tangent again, right? So here is another inverse tangent, plus inverse tangent of the input, which is just x. So that's pretty much it. In the end, we'll just distribute the negative 1 over 4 and call it for the day. No, not really, because we still have to do the power series. Anyway, here we go. This is 1 over 4 x to the fourth power inverse tangent of x. This times that is negative 1 over 12 x to the third power. This times that becomes plus 1 over 4 x. And this times that, this is minus 1 over 4 inverse tangent of x. Unfortunately, this and that cannot be combined. This right here is it. We will be putting down the plus C, and that's it for the answer, like that. I will label this as C1 because I'll use another constant later on right here, so we will see. Anyway, that's good. Now, by power series, so I'll put this down right here, by power series. Of course, we have to know the power series of the inverse tangent of x. So, that's, you know, you have to just know that. I'll put this down right here for you guys though. We know that the inverse tangent of x, this right here is the sum. And of course, for further information, you guys can check out my other video on how we derive this, but I will put this down right here. Its n goes from 0 to infinity, and we have negative 1 to the nth power over, and here we have 2n plus 1 times x to the 2n plus 1, right? Just like that. And then, let's see, we still have to multiply by x to the third power in the front. This is what we know. And we just have to take care of some more business. Well, I just have to multiply x to the third power, and we will also multiply by x to the third power here. That's it, right? And we can get the power series out of that. So in another word, we will just get the following. If we want to integrate x to the third power inverse tangent of x dx, we can now just integrate, well, this part. But perhaps I should bring this, right? X to the third power, we should distribute right here. So altogether, it becomes 2n plus 4. This is plus 1, and then you have 3 more, so 2n plus 4. Let me put this down right here for you guys, for the power series, for the function here. We have the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity. This right here stays negative 1 to the nth power over 2n plus 1. But here we have x to the 2n, again, this and that together is plus 4. So this is how we can get power series for this function based on what we know, right? So that's pretty much the idea. This is the power series for that, and of course, put down the dx. Well, we haven't integrated yet. Now we will. Just need to focus on this part really nicely, right? And I should also tell you guys, I forgot to say, the power series for the inverse tangent has the radius of convergence 1. The interval of convergence is negative 1 to 1, including both n. But we are not going to worry about that. I will just tell you r is equal to 1, right? So when we integrate that, the r will still be equal to 1. That's good. Anyway, finally, we are going to integrate. Right here, just add 1 to it, which is 2n plus 5 for the new power, and divided by that, so we put this power in the denominator. And guess what? We are done with the integration. So I will tell you, this right here is equal to, just pretty much write this down again. Sum as n goes from 0 to infinity, negative 1 to the nth power over, this times that, 2n plus 1 times 2n plus 5, and here we have x to the 2n plus 5 power. And you see, if I put a plus c right here, it might be a little bit confusing because I don't want the c to be inside of the summation. So usually, the way we do it is we erase the equal sign. We say c plus this thing. But, you know, earlier I labeled that as c1. The c's might be different, so it should be c2. Well, this is it. And again, when you integrate or differentiate power series, the radius of convergence, they will stay the same. It's just that we will have to double check and triple check the convergence at the endpoints, right? So that's the interval of convergence. But this is it for that. That's it. So